Today's topic is a nice one.
Yes.
Like the banning of zoo.
Yeah, the ban of zoo.
Ban of zoo. So the first question here is, what could be the reasons for... what is your opinion on banning zoos?
Okay. The first thing, I think whenever they started the zoo, so that time there was only one goal. That to, you know, preserve the animals and how to protect them. They started, that is only one goal. I think later on it become a very worse condition and not, it is not in well. And that is why it's a one line nowadays going like, you know, juice would be bad. And why I am saying that it should be, because definitely, you know, there is two or three points I would like to say. Like, first, not enough space, I think. You know, if there is wild animal, they can roam here and there in forest, everywhere. So there is good space. But I think it's not in zoo. And sometime also, you know, they are suffering from, I think, mental and physically some hazards. Because, you know, like, zoo is just like a prison for them. So we are keeping them. So definitely this is affecting their mind and sometime also their, you know, body. So if it's happening, so this is against the law of animals law. It should be also. And the second, third one, I would like to share that, you know, I think the propagation, it is happening, not like a preservation, because there is a, must be preservation if you are keeping animals in the zoo. So if it is not happening in a way, in the right way, so what's the use of the zoo? So it is better to ban it. Because, you know, nowadays we can see the animals, they are less than earlier. What is this? This everything is affecting them. There is technical things, there is many, you know, machineries things, and now not much enough space for animals. So if they are already, they don't have space, and you are keeping them in zoos continuously, so this is not good for them. I think this is against the law as well. Because just like a human, they can raise their voice for their law, but not animals. So this is our sense that what we have to do. That is why I think it should be bad.
It is a kind of torture for them. Torturing the animals. Right.
Torture, right. Because they can't speak and we are doing this.
So their animals are meant to be in the forest, not in the zoo.
Definitely, definitely. Just like birds, you know. And there are bird sanctuary as well. But in sanctuary, I think there is good space than these zoos. And sometime I think if there is surplus animal in zoos, maybe they would kill. Because there is no space. So like this. And
That's true. That is what happens.
So I think it is harmful for animals.
And most of the animals in the zoo are affected by some kind of physical or mental diseases.
Yes, right. Because they can't speak, they can't utter the things what they are feeling. And continuously what we are doing, and we don't care about that. So definitely it is affecting their mind, their body.
Exactly. Okay, so now we spoke about like why the animals should not be kept in zoos. So is there any reason why animals should be kept in zoos?
Okay. Yeah, so initially as I said, like, you know, it's a goal to protect the animals and to keep them in a zoo, and you know, also treat them, you know, like a human being, treat them a good way. So that is why zoo and it is also an entertainment for others, for humans, you know. And but as I said, there is some good parts and some bad parts. So definitely, if we are saying that why we are capturing them in zoos, so yeah, because we can cure them at the right time, sometime, you know, the physical disease if happen, so we can see and we can cure, because this is our responsibility in zoos. So at the time we can cure them. These are some advantages.
And it's used for educational purpose also, right? Like for children.
Yeah, yeah. Education person, I think purpose also, because if students, they are just coming and seeing the things and animals, so virtually, I think directly they can understand more the things than book is thing.
Okay, it's like a kind of practical rather than theory.
Rather than theory, definitely, you're right.
So. In books and videos, they cannot see the real size of the animal, right? In books, they will see the only picture, and even in the video, they can only see the picture, moving picture. But they cannot see the real size of an elephant or the real size of a lion, tiger. So at that time, it might be very useful for them to.
Yes, yes. It is very useful, right?
And I believe rather than keeping the animals in cages, animals and birds in cages, we can do something like animal safari that is happening nowadays. Like animal safari, what? So people will be like, the audience will be inside the cage, right? Audience will be inside the cage and they will go to the forest and they will look at them. That is safest for animals.
Yeah, because definitely, means if we are talking about zoos, so anything happening inside that, you know, and which everyone, I think, doesn't know who is there, they can know very well. And they have to raise their voice for this. And they also should, you know, raise things, whatever in the zoos. Then I think much space and some facilities for them if it is not available for animals. And fooding, many things.
Okay, okay. So have you visited the zoo recently?
No, I didn't.
During your childhood?
Yeah, might be once I visited, but there is not good memory.
Don't have a memory of
it. No.
Do you have a zoo in your place, near your place?
No, in my place there is no, so we have to go around I think 180 km away from our locality.
So, it's too long.
Yeah, it is too long. That is why we don't go.
Okay, since you are in a village, like it is very common to see some animals, right? Like sometimes you might see animals, right?
Yeah.
So
that
come across anything like seeing an animal?
Yeah, like you know, jackal. So it is very common in my side. We can see every time. They are roaming here and there, sometime in front, outdoors. Just like street dogs. Yeah, just like street dogs, so jackals are roaming here. It's very common. And peacock, if I say about that, you know, bird. So peacock is very common. It is the always, you know, sometime in our roof and sometime in front of door. So it is also. So we also watching interesting animals and birds in our locality, in our village. So that is why we don't always, you know, ask to go zoo.
No need of going to zoo.
Yes.
Are coming to your place.
Yeah. Only dangerous animal is not here.
So jackal is not an dangerous animal?
Yeah, it's not dangerous. It's not. It is just like a street dog. We can treat them. Even you know, jackal, they also have fear to the human, I think. If they see to you, just run away. So like this. Antelope, it is also.
Antelope, okay. That is not harmful, right? That's a kind of variety, deer variety, right?
Yeah, right.
And jackals, but jackals are harmful to the chickens, right? They will take away chicken.
Yes. So we have to be careful. Definitely, sometime. it is also if you know the young one's child, so it is also dangerous for them. It, yeah. You know, sometimes we have heard that news, and they kept, you know, and some child from their home. So like this, we have to be careful a little bit if there is any children and young ones in your home.
Okay, that's true. That's true.
Yeah.
So have you come across any kind of tiger visited your village? Tiger, leopard? No.
No, no, not tiger.
Elephants?
Elephant, I think elephant we saw sometime. It is not as common as jackal, but it is also, and elephant, I think camel. So we have seen it in my side. Sometimes I think people use it for traveling here and there, and there some job. Some people are doing job begging with elephant and camels. So that's why.
So what is your opinion on that? Like, they are using elephants for begging. So what is your opinion on that?
Okay, and the first thing, they are giving you and child's a live example. They can see, they can touch, even they also give you a small ride, I think. So if you give, I think, some money. So but so good for them. Just and it is also, they are pet animals. They are already trained, so it's not dangerous. So good to roam here and there. They are also doing their job, and you are just entertaining yourself and your kids. So no issue.
No issues. Okay. So sometimes these when it comes to elephants, sometimes it might become dangerous, right? Sometimes.
Yeah, it is not properly, I think, trained, and maybe if they have any mental issue.
So yeah, mental.
Yeah.
Suddenly, elephants can go mad.
Yes.
Especially when they are hungry and during some season, it will become mad.
Mad. Yeah. Right.
So when it becomes mad, it's very hard to control it.
It is very hard, really, really.
Nobody can control.
So that's why it is a bit hard, dangerous, you can say.
Can even kill his owner.
Sometimes they also can injured by this habit. But yes, it is a risky as well.
And what about snakes? I believe you might have seen a lot of snakes.
Yeah, it's a very common,
very common thing.
Snakes are very common even in rainy season, so it is a alternative day. You can see they are roaming sometime in front of door, and sometime it is so much common in rainy season rather than other season, because in rainy season I think just because of rain they are come out from water and roaming here and there. So we, and in this, if I would like to share one experience in this, we just have passed. So that time we saw one snake that was permanent, permanent 1 week in our home. Means just we were saying continuously. So we thought now we should be, kill this. And then it happened.
Oh, it stayed in your home for a week.
Yeah, means we were just thinking when it, this snake would just leave our home, because we didn't want to kill that. But it wasn't happened, then we had to do that.
Okay. Okay, that was scary. So how you will not get sleep, right? Like if there is a snake in your home, how will you get sleep?
Yeah, so means that was not in my home, but in front of home, sometime roaming, and sometime under like a storeroom. So just come and hide. So it happened.
Okay.